Imagine if you master triggers and states in articulate storyline. You could build the coolest interactions. And therefore, in this video, I'll teach you step by step how you can use triggers and states in articulate storyline for your next e-learning project. So let's start with states in articulate storyline. Now, a state in articulate storyline is a certain state of an object, and the easiest way to explain this is a button in storyline. So let's add one, and to add a button, I'll go to my insert tab here. I click on button, I select this button, and I draw it on my slide. Now, and when my button is selected, I can type text in it, for instance, button. I can also add an arrow, and I can also align the arrow at the other side. So now I have a button with an arrow key. And the next step is to show the states of this button. So when you select the button, and you can see it with the squares around it, you can here go to the states tab and you'll see that a button has different states. So there's a normal state, there's a hover state when a user hovers with the mouse over the button, there's a down state when a user clicks the button, there's a visited state, this becomes visible when a user clicks the button, and there is a disabled state, and the disabled state is used when a button is not clickable. For instance, a button that doesn't work if a user has not yet entered a question on the slide. Now you can change the different states by clicking here on the edit states button. Now you see that you can click on a different state, for instance the visited state, and now we can edit something. So for instance, I select my state and I give the button a different fill. So instead of blue, I get it green, and you'll see that now only the visited state has a green background. But I could also change the icon, for instance a question mark, and you'll see that only the visited state has a question mark and not all the other states. Now, and if you're ready, you can click on the done editing states button, and the editing things that you've done on your states are saved. Now, almost every object in storyline can have states, and we have seen that a button already has a set of predefined states by default. But if we, for instance, make a shape, then you can see that storyline only gives it a standard or a normal state. So let's insert the shape right now. So I'll go to my insert tab, choose shape, for instance pick a rectangle, and I draw a rectangle on my screen here, and you see on the states tab that the rectangle only has a normal state. But you have also the possibility to give objects in storyline custom states. How can you do this? You can click the edit states button for the rectangle, and now you see there's only one state, but if you click this one button, the new state button, you can create new states. So here you can find the built-in states, but you can also create your own states. For instance, if I call this new state, there is now a new state on this rectangle. What storyline does if you create a new state is it copies the normal state, and it will copy it to the state that you are creating. And you can add extra objects to your state, even videos. So I have selected my state right now, and if I click my insert button and I go to caption and I draw a caption here, you see now that this state has a caption and this block in it, and this state has only a rectangle in it. So, and there's a last thing that I want to talk about states. So let's click on done editing states, and that is that you can select an initial state of an object. So with the initial state, this is the state that storyline shows when a user comes to this slide. So here I see the initial state is set to normal, but I can also choose for my new state, and now you see the rectangle and the caption, but I can also choose as initial state hidden, and now the object is hidden from the slide and you can let it appear with triggers. So, and that's the next step. So let's move on to triggers to see what you can do with triggers and states to build cool interactions in storyline. So you can use triggers in articulate storyline to perform actions at a specific moment. Now, and to create a new trigger in storyline, you go to your triggers panel on the right and click on new. Now, storyline will now open the trigger window for you, and in storyline, triggers are always made up of three components. And the first component is what happens in the trigger. So in this example, there's an action that says jump to slide. So what happens is we are jumping to a slide, and here we can see which slide. Now it's the next slide, but it can also be another slide. For instance, a previous slide or a specific slide in our project. Now, and the second component is when does it happen? And it happens when a user clicks. And the third component is where it happens, and that you can find here under object, and it happens when a user clicks on this object rectangle one. Now let's create a new trigger. So let's cancel this one. Here we have the rectangle that has a hidden state. And now let's create a trigger on the button here that shows the rectangle when we click on the button. So the first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select the button, and now I'll go to new trigger. And the first question that I ask myself by creating a new trigger is, what want I do to happen here? So I want to change the state of this object. So by action here, I choose the trigger change state of. Which state do I want to change? The state of this object. So it's not the object of the button, but the object of the rectangle. So, and to which state we want to change it? We can change it to normal. And when do we want to happen? When the user clicks. And we want to happen it when the user clicks on this button. And now I can click OK. And now let's preview our slide to see what happens. So we are now on the preview mode. And if I click my button, you see that rectangle appears and the button changes to the visit state. And this is now on the normal state. So, but you can do more with triggers. So let's close this preview state, continue to the next example. So another example to use triggers and states is to change the state of a menu item. Now I have here a first slide in my project. It's a menu slide and I have here four menu items. And let's select the first menu item. I have also selected it. And if I see on the states tab, you'll see there's one state, normal, and it has multiple objects in it. Now what we're gonna do is to add a completed state. So a user can see that he completed this chapter. So click on Added States, click on New State, and I fill in Completed, and click on Add. And you'll see Storyline now copies the normal state, and I have to copy the text. So let's copy it here and paste it on this state, so it also has the text. So you see I have now two states, a normal state and a complete state. But I want to add a check mark, so a user can see that he completed this menu. So I'll go to Insert, I'll go to Shapes, and I choose here the check mark, states, I'll choose my check mark, and I draw my check mark here, and go to Format, the Format tab, and I create a green shape and also a green outline. And you'll see my completed state now has a green check mark on it. So, and the next step is to add a trigger that's executed when the timeline starts. And this trigger will check if a certain value is true, for instance, a variable. And when this value is true, the trigger will be executed and the state of this object will be set to completed. Now, if you want to know more about variables and how you can use them in Storyline, I've put a card to my video about variables here at the right, so you can click it. And again, watch my video about variables on how to use variables in Storyline. But now let's add our trigger. So what I've done do here now, I click done editing states. I'll go to my triggers panel. I click the trigger and my trigger whistle will open. I choose here for change state off. So I'll go to my triggers panel, click new trigger. The action is change state off. Which object? Menu item one. I want to change it to completed. And when I want to do this, I want to do this when the timeline starts on this slide. Now, if I execute this trigger, it means that every time this slide will run and the timeline will start, this state will be changed from normal to completed. But that is something that I don't want. Because what we are going to do is create a variable. So I click on OK here. I click here on my variables chip. And I create a new true false variable that I name chapter 1 completed. And the default value is false. So, and I click on OK here. Now can we go back to our trigger? So, and I gonna place a condition here. So I want this trigger only executed when my variable chapter 1 completed is equal to true. And I click on OK. So what you can do in your course, for instance, on the last page of a chapter, is set a trigger. For instance, a trigger that does not change, that says adjust variable. and that sets contents of the variable change one chapter one completed to true when the timeline starts. Now when this variable is on true and you continue to the menu slide again, this menu item will be set to completed, and the user can see that he's completed the first chapter. So these were a couple of examples of triggers, but there are lots of other examples. So let's see what the examples are. So for instance, if I click on my triggers panel here, for with the actions, you can see now we've used change state of and also the adjust variable, but you have a show layer, hide layer, jump to slide, jump to scene, jump to a specific time on your timeline, a show a slide as a lightbox, close the lightbox, move an object, play media, pause it, stop it, restart the course, exit course, pause your timeline, resume it, open a specific file, send an email, execute JavaScript, and submit interactions. But also when a trigger must be executed, there are several options. So let's see here, we used when timeline starts, but there are mouse events, user clicks, user right clicks, user hovers over, object events, so a state change, an animation completes, an object intersects, so this is something to do with moving, when a slider moves or a dial turns, a variable change, the media completes, user presses a specific key. So you see there are a lot of possibilities to use triggers in your storyline projects. So if you use triggers, states, variables, and also slide layers, you could really build cool interactions. So I hope I'll inspire you with this video to build new interactions in your next storyline project.
Do you have any questions about embedding your Articulate Storyline course in WordPress or about Articulate Storyline in common? Then place a comment below these videos and I promise to answer it. And if you want to create great engaging URL in Articulate Storyline, make sure that you get my free step-by-step guide on how I create e-learning in Articulate Storyline. And I know for sure that it will help you because it describes my whole process that I use for every e-learning module in Articulate Storyline that I build. And was this video useful to you? Then hit the like button below. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell notification icon so you won't miss any of my upcoming videos.